Right now, the world is experiencing a devastating health pandemic, the highly infectious coronavirus causing the disease we call COVID-19. In this Think video, we'll dive into the science and tell you everything we know so far about what this coronavirus is and how it actually attacks our bodies, using our own immune system against us. Let's start talking about what a coronavirus actually is. When you think about what a coronavirus looks like, you probably picture a spiky red ball like the images circulating in the media. However, this virus is actually named after its crown-like structure, the spikes on the surface of its lipid membrane, the same membrane that is destroyed easily when we use soap. Of course, this image is much bigger than the actual virus, which is so tiny you'd need a very powerful electron microscope to see it. It's thought that this virus jumped from bats to humans in a process called zoonosis. Not all viruses can jump between species. Some viruses like rabies, HIV, SARS, or MERS have been observed to do this. The coronaviridae family contains more than 30 different species of coronaviruses, and of these, 7 can jump from animals to humans. 3 of these jumping diseases have proven to be deadly. SARS-CoV or severe acute respiratory syndrome. This disease emerged in 2003 and killed 1 out of 10 people that it infected. Scientists think the virus causing this disease was transmitted through civet cats. A decade later, MERS-CoV emerged in the Middle East and caused the disease MERS, also known as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. The coronavirus causing this disease was transmitted through camels and is extremely dangerous, killing up to 37% of people who catch it. And now, this new strain of coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2, is causing a global outbreak that began in Wuhan, China, in 2019. The disease it causes is called Coronavirus Disease 2019, or COVID-19. Scientists think this strain of coronavirus jumped from bats to pangolins, a type of anteater, and then to humans. The COVID-19 disease starts when this new coronavirus infects a cell in our airway after entering through our mouth, nose, or eyes. The virus hijacks that host cell by attaching itself to a specific tiny protein called ACE2 on the cell's surface. This process works like a key to open the cell's door and get inside by fusing its own membrane with that of the cell. Once inside the cell, the virus releases a piece of its own genetic material called RNA. This tiny piece of RNA hijacks the existing machinery in the cell to make many more copies of the virus. You can think of this hijacking process as being like an assembly line in a factory. Your cells produce all the proteins your body needs to function, and they contain DNA, which is like the instruction manual that tells the assembly line which proteins to make. How this virus attacks is by using its own RNA instructions to force your cell's assembly line to produce different proteins. And these are the proteins that make up more copies of the virus. It's scary and it's ingenious. Because it lives inside one of your body's own cells, the coronavirus is pretty much hidden from your immune system. The virus can then make lots of copies of itself by using your cell's own machinery. To make it worse, the virus can then cause the cell to self-destruct and release millions of viruses into your body. These copies then attach themselves to nearby cells, hijack their machinery, and create even more copies of the coronavirus. Each infected cell can release millions of copies of the virus before the cell finally breaks down and dies. The viruses may infect nearby cells or even end up in droplets that escape the lungs to infect more people around you. As this hijacking and self-destruction happens, your body's immune system reacts, and this is why most COVID-19 infections cause a fever to fight the virus. With very bad infections, the immune system can even react too strongly and begin attacking your lungs' cells, which fills them with fluid and dead cells. If your lungs starts to become filled up with all this junk, you can find it hard or even impossible to breathe. This is called acute respiratory distress syndrome, and it can be very painful and kill you. Your own immune system stops you from being able to get enough oxygen into your cells. This is why ventilators are so important for hospitals fighting COVID-19, to make sure people can get enough oxygen into their bodies even while their lungs are failing. While we've known how viruses work for decades, we're only just learning about how exactly this specific SARS-CoV-2 virus gets into your lungs and how it spreads and kills humans at the rate it's doing. Click on the subscribe button and that little bell icon to keep up with our latest expert-led videos.